gosh, what an absolutely massive play to start the game.
If he gets rid of the save, he gets the one-hit KO!
Hey everybody, welcome back to another week of Fight for First. This season's been pretty good to us so far, and normally we'd switch up the team more often than you're seeing, but I really don't have a good reason to yet, so I'm gonna stick with it for a while until we have a good reason to actually make a switch, because otherwise, like, I mean, the team's doing well. I can't complain. So if I mess with something, it might just mess with us winning. I do want to two things before we start. First, if I never ever respond to your comments, I know I can't respond to every single person, but if you're that person who's like, I never get like a physical word response from Alex, your settings are set up so I can't respond. That's Google Plus for you. Go into your Google Plus account, change your settings so people can reply. I mean, if you want to, you don't have to. And then, you know, I can't comment, I can't reply to everybody every time, but if I'm never ever ever replying to you, that's probably the reason why. I wake up every morning and I go through my comments and I try to respond to a lot of them. So that's one. Sometimes I'm lazy too, I mean, to be honest, but whatever. Second thing is, I get a lot of requests for like, hey Alex, can you rate my team? Hey Alex, what are your EV spreads? Blah, 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 blah. And so I wanted a way to fix that while also, you know, doing it. I don't know what the word I'm looking for is. I was an English major for 2 weeks, okay? It's not my fault. 2 weeks is not a lot of time to learn all of the English language. Anyway, so what I decided to do, and the best way to do it, is you really need like a face-to-face interaction. For someone to help you with your team, for someone to give you good advice, you need face-to-face interaction, and you need that person to actually play with your team. So, you see my Twitch link down there, right there at the bottom. What I'm doing is, instead of actually having like Twitch's subscription thing, it's, you know, Twitch charges you guys $4.99 to subscribe to someone, and they take half of it. So instead of that, I created a Patreon page, and basically the Patreon page is for people who want me, or who are interested in getting like actual team help, or actually looking at my real EV spreads. I honestly don't know what they are, but I could reset bag everything if I, you know, I will end up doing that. If you want my EV spreads, if you want what teams I'm thinking of, you know, thoughts like that, or if you want that one-on-one interaction, it's actually less than it would be on Twitch. So instead of becoming like a Twitch subscriber, because I think they're taking half is kind of crazy. Patreon only takes like 5%, and then there's like a maximum 5% other processing fee. 10% is way better than 50%. On there, there's like a $1 category and a $3 category, and it's monthly. But if you're interested in that, you know, I'll stream a couple times a week, specifically with the intent of helping people with their teams and working through team problems. You guys will be put into a separate group chat, and you know, I'll answer your questions in depth. You know, because I usually can't deal with everybody. There's so many of you guys. But if I can, you know, take these people who are like, okay, this is something I'm really interested in, this is worthwhile to me, put you guys in your own group chat or whatever. I'll be able to look through your teams. I'll actually pick out people randomly. I'll take your team. I'll play through it 10, 20 times to actually get a real feel for it and tell you what I think is working and what isn't working. And that should be helpful not only to you, but to everyone who's watching. That process is really, really helpful. So I think it'll be a good way of actually being able to address people's questions like that. Because I get messages all the time all over the place on Facebook, whatever. They're like, hey, can you look at my team? Blah, 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 blah. Rate my team sections are never very successful because people aren't actually playing your team. You can't really just look at something and be like, okay, well, this is why it's not working, without playing through it, unless there's something really blatantly obviously wrong with your team. And that being said, you know, I'm not going to make you use, you know, meta mons if you don't want to. If you really want to use Vileplume, we'll try to figure out a way to make that work. But so I'll have a link in there. At least it should be up by today, Monday. So check it out if you're interested in that. Even donating, like I said, there's a $1 category and a $3 category. They're both super cheap and way less than what Twitch was doing. So if you were thinking of being like a Twitch subscriber, that'll be a good alternative. If you're on the list on Twitch, you're automatically in the special group. You're in there for life. So don't worry about that. Is there anything else on here? So yeah, so there's that option. And I'll be streaming a couple times a week for, you know, with that intent. So if that's what you really want, that's that. Anyway, sorry that took so long. Let's hop into this battle. Let's get started, because it's Monday, and we got to do this. We got to do it. Whew. Man, I need to drink some water. That was a lot of talking. Look at this. All of this thirst right here. Quenched. 18, 28, 26, and 3. Not bad. Not bad. We're doing all right. We're going to try to shoot for as much as we can. 1856 from Japan, Tokyo. Oh my gosh. wow, look at this team. Okay, I hate dealing with Sylveon. Our team's not ready to deal with Sylveon. And he's got the Con Lando thing, which is really strong. Lando, Sylveon, Thundurus, Bisharp, which is going to scare away my own Landorus, and that Blaziken, which is probably the Life Orb HP Ice Speed Boost thing. Okay, that's gonna one-shot my Amoongus, and my Amoongus is really the way we take out Sylveon, so we're... This is scary. This is definitely scary. Rotom is not gonna do too poorly, actually. I like Rotom here. I like Melodic as long as we don't give the Bisharp boosts. Do I like my Landorus? A little bit. It'll help curb the Kangaskhan, but I'm not sure if it's worth it. I think the Thundurus, though, is the real question. Do we bring the Thundurus or the Amoongus or the Melodic? Those three. I need to fit two of them in here. And I gotta figure out where I want to put everything. I almost want to go Amoongus Thundurus. But if he goes with the Landorus... The thing is, like, we need to switch in for the really big Sylveon. Okay. Is this worth it all? Honestly, is this even worth? Yeah, because I need to taunt his Thundurus in case he starts with it. Heat's really good here. It's really good, guys. It's just a good Pokemon. I think I'll bring it. It's faster than Bisharp, too. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it. Little scary. Sylveon. Big Hyper Voice is a huge problem to this team. We've been pretty lucky recently. We haven't run into a whole lot of Sylveon, but now we're playing someone who's pretty well-rated, and something that, if protected pretty well, is going to give us a lot of trouble. So, we'll see here. That is Japanese for Bisharp and Blaziken. Okay, so he's fishing for the Landorus start. Not going to give it to him. More than anything, I'd love to just Thunder Wave that Blaziken. I don't think he'll let me do that, though. So, what's the Bisharp going to do? I think the Blaziken is going to protect, and the Bisharp is going to knock off. Unless it's Taunt Bisharp. You know Tyranitar gets Taunt? Yeah, weird stuff. I can't imagine the Blaziken is just going to attack this turn. What do we think? I don't think so. I think I'm going to Thunderbolt the Bisharp, and I'm going to Spore it. I really think the Blaziken is going to protect. It's so obvious, right? It'd be too obvious to just overheat. Okay, we'll go with the prediction. We'll find out. It's Mega Blaziken. Well, that... Okay, what? This man's running double Mega because he's got Kangaskhan on there. Oh my god. Okay, thank god for that. Because otherwise, we were in trouble. Big Thunderball here. We'll see if it's sashed or not. Oh, we didn't even get the KO. That's scary. So we're not going to know. There's the knockoff on the Thundurus. Biggest of damage. Okay, well, that sucks, because if we were still alive... Oh, there's the Life Orb. Great. Great. Because if we were still alive, we could at least Thunder Wave the Blaziken. Which is going to be a problem now. I was not expecting that to be a thing. Okay. Let's see. What's the damage calc on Kangaskhan getting Mega Blaziken? Even at -1, because we got to be afraid of his Landorus switching in. I really cannot believe this is Mega Blaziken. Let's get Return on here. Let's make this Addy. Yeah, we get it, but not if we're at -1. The thing is, if we don't send in the Kangaskhan, my Rotom really can't stop it. I'm going to send in Kangaskhan. Hopefully he does not have Landorus. We're going to wait and see. What is that? Thundurus. Hey, what's up, Thundy? Okay, cool. Which means our Rotom Heat does a lot of work to everything in the back here. There's no way he brought Kangaskhan. There's no way. It's got to be Landorus or Sylveon. This is my one chance to hit that Blaziken. I'm going to do it. I'm going to Rage Powder here, too. I think he's going to Taunt. I really do. So let's Rage Powder, and let's go for the hit. He protected last turn, so... Yeah, I'm not gonna risk him kicking my Kangaskhan. We've definitely lost Kangaskhan before, anticipating him not to kick because of a Rage Powder. So let's Rage Powder. Let's just be safe. If he switches, he switches to Lando. Honestly, if he brought Lando, then he really had no way to stop Milotic. So I can't believe an 1858 would do that. And if it's Sylveon, then at least we get the Sylveon down. Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. I hope he stays in. He's staying in. This is awesome. This is awesome. Rage Powder should go first because of the increased priority. Unless he went for a double protect. Or unless he built it to survive. No, he could not have. This is it's a pretty solid damage. 109 to 129 without any investment. Even if it survives, we'll at least be able to Sucker Punch KO it. And it can't be Goggles because it's Mega. Okay, he went for the attack. Definitely worthwhile to lose this Amoongus to get rid of that Blaziken. Definitely worthwhile. Really depends on what he's got in the back here, but like I said, I can't imagine he brought Lando. Switching to Rotom Heat there would have been awesome. I really wish actually we had done that, because we basically had this game wrapped up. But if it's Sylveon like I think it is, we're gonna be fine. That's Landorus, isn't it? Oh, it's Sylveon. Yes. Rotom pretty much ends this game, actually. So, it is Sylveon, so we were right. So, calculation's correct. Sylveon's either got Protect or it doesn't, okay? Okay, that's obvious. I didn't just state the obvious. But the thing is, if he's got Protect, will he Protect on this turn? Probably. So I'm going to double Protect here to try to waste out his Protect. See if he's got a Protect. No use in taking damage if we don't have to. I mean, I could attack with a Rotom, but like I said, I don't want to just take unnecessary damage. We will get the KO on this Sylveon with the Kangaskhan. So let's bait out the Protect, keep everything as healthy as possible. If he doesn't have Protect, I don't want to take a free Hyper Voice, even though we are Fire, you know? We don't have a Citrus Berry on Rotom. So let's do that. He's hoping for Hacks. This battle's gonna come down to that. It absolutely is gonna come down to that. So we're gonna return. In case he built it to survive, what are the chances there? It's possible. I'm gonna double into it. There's no harm in doing that. So I'm gonna double into the Sylveon. I don't think it's running Protect. It all comes down to this, actually, right here. If we attack through Paralysis. Yes, that should be our game. Perfect, we got him. Unless some kind of crazy swagger stuff happens right now. That should be the game. 1858, yeah, no, it's pretty good. Okay, that's really bulky. So it's not gonna do a whole lot of damage to us. We brought that into a 75% win chance. Let's see, well, we have a little bit of time here. What was the big thing? Okay, being caught off guard by the Blaziken, that was huge. Getting KO'd by the Bisharp, that was pretty scary, because we didn't have our Thunderous to come in and take it later. And then playing it safe with Amoongus, also a little terrifying, but it all ended up working out because it all ended up in a 75% win chance. It's a big risk management game. We very easily could have lost if we got full paired, but you play the odds, right? And the odds said we probably should win this. I'm going to Will-O-Wisp him. It'll do more damage than a couple Thunderbolts. Because we're going to probably be here for a couple turns. Okay, we got him. Nice. So, wow. Yes, 1858. We took him down. That's good stuff. If you guys are interested in that Patreon thing, I'll put a link, obviously, in the description. No pressure. It doesn't really matter. Either way, if you do go in, I have, there's, a special Patreon posting thing. That's where I'll be posting, my EV spreads and stuff for all the new Pokemon I use. And talking about, which new team ideas I have, or, behind-the-scenes stuff. So if you're interested in that, or if you have ad block and you feel bad, the $1 one, it's pretty chill. That's a cool way to still support, the creator while still blocking ads. I don't care if you guys block. To be honest, I don't care what you guys do. I'm just glad you guys come and you enjoy the content and you're supporting me, and it's making me play a lot. So I like that. That's enough for me. But in case that's not the case, but like I said, no pressure. thanks so much for being here. This is what matters to me. If you guys want that little bit of extra help, that little bit of personal, you know, I'm gonna, you know, that's what that's for. I just wanted that to be an option. It's better than doing the Twitch subscription thing, and that's $5 a month, like I said, and then they take half. So I think that's basically piracy. So I thought this was a better alternative. Either way, thanks so much, guys. Thanks for being here. Happy Monday. Hopefully our points are boosting, and yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow on another episode of Fight for First.